Hello, my friends. I'm Brett Larkin, and this is the Yoga Hacks Podcast. And today we are talking about yoga for chronic fatigue. This podcast was spurred by a question that was written into me on my private Facebook group. If you are not a member of our private Facebook group, you definitely want to join because that's where all of us hang out. Yogahackscommunity.com. So that's yoga, H-A-C-K-S, community.com will redirect you to the Facebook group and I can approve you as a member. And this question about chronic fatigue and what kind of yoga to do and can yoga help with chronic fatigue is really a little bit more complex, which is why I wanted to put it into a podcast instead of just writing a generic answer on Facebook. So for the purposes of this conversation, what I want to do is I actually want to divide chronic fatigue or tiredness or just feeling really tired and lethargic into three categories, because I think those three categories will require a different type of yoga class for them. So category number one, or tiredness, type of tiredness number one, is what I like to kind of call physical depletion and tiredness. You are physically tired and physically worn out, and this is most likely because you pushed yourself too hard on that ski trip last weekend. You filmed 8 classes in a row, like I do sometimes when you had a professional camera guy with you at your house. You went for a really long run and maybe strained something, right? So after you do a really hardcore workout and you overextend, you overdid it, there is like a fatigue that is associated with over-exercising, overworking. And that's what I'm going to call type one, like too much physical exertion and now you're fatigued and tired. Okay, so let's talk about that first. So when you're in that situation, the answer is yes, do yoga. Still do yoga. But you're going to want to do super gentle yoga. So I would suggest doing my lazy yoga sequence, and I will put links below this podcast. So if you're on SoundCloud, look in the description. If you're listening to this on YouTube, expand the description. Always expand the description of all videos on YouTube, guys, because I put a lot of helpful links in there. And so I will put links below for each of these different sort of categories. So physical exertion, I would do like lazy yoga, like yin yoga, any of my yin sequences, and I'll put specific suggestions down. You want to take it easy, but you still want to move. And I'm actually coming out with a class pretty soon that's called Too Sore to Move. It's a class that I've had like in editing for like almost a year. It's ridiculous. And it's like the exact yoga sequence that I do when I'm in this state of tiredness due to too much physical exertion. It's like, I'm too sore to move, but you still want to move. And the reason is, like, usually if you physically exerted yourself, overexerted yourself, there's like this lactic acid buildup in your muscles and you feel really sore. But the reality is if you just move a little bit, gentle movements, think cat cow, think simple little twists, think yin style, it's going to actually speed up your recovery time. So you're going to feel better faster and it'll also just improve your energy, your mood, everything else. Okay, the second type of fatigue I'm going to talk about is mental overload, stress, like worst week at work of your life, in the middle of planning your wedding or some crazy event, or, you know, just like when you've had those days, those weeks, or you just feel so tired and it's really more about your head. You didn't go for like a super hard hike and your body's fatigued. It's like your brain is in fatigue. And in that case, I really recommend meditation. I think what I suggested for case one, where it's like physical fatigue, is good too. Gentle movement's gonna be good. Yin is gonna be amazing. But this is really where your meditation, and when I say meditation, it's so funny. Like when I say meditation, I'm really talking about doing pranayama. I'm talking about doing a breathing practice. If you just sit and try to meditate, for me at least, it's very hard. It often doesn't work. It's really hard to just sort of snap into stillness. And if you're not focusing on your breath, you're just sitting there and thinking about your grocery list or whatever, it's not even really meditating. So when I say meditation, sorry, what I'm really saying is to do some structured breathing, like alternate nostril breathing. I have this incredible meditation called Meditation for Nervous Energy, which would be great for when you're really, really fatigued like this. So you want to do a seated breath practice with structured breath work where you're holding the breath in for a certain amount of counts, making the inhales and exhales equal length, all of that kind of good stuff leading into a gentle meditation. So with type of fatigue one, it's more about your physical body is fatigued, and I would just definitely move, definitely do yoga, because again, it's going to help with that lactic acid buildup and make you feel better, and meditation's optional. With the second kind of fatigue, which is more about mental stress, overwhelm, I really would focus on meditation and then gentle yoga being the optional other thing. Okay, so now we're ready to talk about number three, which I think is what the person who wrote in on Facebook was most interested in, and that's like chronic fatigue, like you always feel tired. And this is an important distinction between type two and type three of fatigue, because type two of fatigue, like we all get like that sometimes, right? We all have hard weeks. We all have days where it just feels like our brain is mush, right? And we can turn to our meditation practice or a very gentle yoga practice to help with that. But if you feel like that all the time, like you always feel tired, unmotivated, like you just want to do a gentle practice, you just want to do a yin practice, you just want to sit, you don't want to move, that is sort of a red flag if you're feeling that way all the time. And if you're feeling that way all the time, what I'm going to suggest is to actually do a vinyasa or more like power yoga type of sequence to shift you out of that chronic fatigue energy. And what I'm really talking about here is like there is a time to baby ourselves, right? When you've had the hardest week at work, your boyfriend just dumped you, right? Whatever, like something really bad just happened. You're in stress, you're in overwhelm. We need to meditate. We need to do yin. We need to do restorative sequences. We need to help the body repair. But if you're feeling like that all the time, I don't want to use the word like you're lazy, but right, like you need to kickstart yourself out of that pattern of wanting to always do sort of like the gentle, easier option. Because now that's not just like you needing to recover because you had a hard week. That's like your default. And if that's your default, you need, you know, yoga's all about balance. Hatha yoga, sun, moon yoga. It's all about balancing your active and your, you know, passive qualities, right? Like everything in yoga is about balance. So, you know, if you're someone who's constantly doing power yoga in Bikram, I'd suggest you go to a yin class and see if you can learn how to chill out, right? So we need balance. So if you're someone who notices you're like chronically fatigued, you always want to do sort of like the easier class, the seated classes, or you really struggle to get to your mat at all, that's where I'm actually going to maybe be a little controversial and say, you know what, maybe you want to try like one of my classes that's 10 minutes, so keep it short, but have it be like a power class. Like I have one called Get Fired Up. You know, maybe you need to try that class, because if you start doing a class that's more active and energy really gets you flowing, really is going to get you moving, it's going to help jumpstart. I really think of it, it's like jumpstarting the ignition of a car. It's going to jumpstart you into that new energy. And this ties into a yogic concept called the gunas. Guna in Sanskrit literally means strand or fiber, but the gunas are the three fundamental forces at play in the universe and within ourselves as well. So rajas is more like the active state, right? It would be like the power yoga class. Tamas, the other guna, so there's three, is the opposite, right? It's like your yin practice. I'm vastly oversimplifying. I encourage you to read more on the gunas, and I can do a whole separate podcast on them as well. And then sattva, the third guna, is that perfect state of balance, that balance between too much energy and lethargy, right? And it is our yoga practice. It's the balance between effort and ease, basically, right? We want to live in the balance between effort and ease. Like the crazy Bikram hardcore person, like they're living too much in effort. And if you claim to be chronically fatigued and you only are doing super easy yoga classes and not challenging yourself, you're kind of maybe living in too much in ease. And whenever I think about the gunas, I like to think about people too. So you can think about, do you have a friend or do you know someone who talks really, really fast and their chin is constantly jutting forward and they're constantly in a rush, right? That like chin jutting forward, like they're living in the front of their body, like they are living in a rajastic state. Okay, and then do you have maybe another friend or someone you can think of who is maybe like very sedentary, very passive? It takes them like a minute to form their thoughts before they respond to you. They're in a tamasic state, right? They're too almost passive. So the ideal, and you know, in certain parts of life, like maybe in the office place or the workplace, right? We need to be in a little bit more of a rajastic energy. And when we're at home getting ready for bed, hopefully we're cultivating more of a tamasic energy. But throughout our life, we want to be in sattva, we want to be in balance. And the great news is that yoga is a tool to get you back into balance. So again, if you're in like type one or type two of fatigue that I described, it's like you went for a really hard hike, the body's in crisis. You need to do a tamastic, you know, slow it down practice. Same thing if your brain is in total overwhelm, you need to take care of that. But if you're just living in a constantly tamastic state where you're never wanting to kind of, you know, do a harder practice or challenge yourself or flow, then you need to push yourself and like go towards the opposite, do a rajastic energizing heating practice, because at the end of it will balance you and you'll be in a sattvic state. So hopefully that makes sense. So in summary, if the body's in crisis or the mind is in crisis, you want to turn to easeful, gentle yoga, and I'll put links below, or a meditation practice if the brain is, you know, you're like total living in overwhelm and stress. But if you're just chronically tired, I want you to do some power yoga classes. I want you to do some of my 10-minute morning routines. Again, they don't have to be an hour-long class. Just do a 10-minute class, but that has those heating qualities. The Get Fired Up class is great. Even the beginner morning yoga sequence is great, right? So you can start shifting in to, for you, what will be a sattvic state, right? A rajastic person might do that class and they'd be like too hyper, right? But if you notice that you're always tired, it's going to help balance you out. And notice the reverse too. Like if you're someone who's always reaching for power yoga, maybe you actually need to do some yin to balance yourself out and get into that place of sattva, that place of balance. So we're constantly trying to balance effort and ease, constantly try to balance our sun and moon qualities. That is ultimately what yoga is all about. And I hope this little podcast was helpful. Make sure to share it. Give it a thumbs up if you're seeing it on SoundCloud or YouTube. Jump on over to my website. Make sure you're on my email list, because that is like the number one way that I communicate about retreats, events that are coming up. You don't want to miss out. And if I don't have you on my email list, there's really no way for us to be in contact with one another. I always love receiving your ideas, questions, requests for new classes or new podcasts through email or through the private Facebook group. Once again, that group is YogaHacks, HACKS community.com. And if you use Periscope, which is a new app where I broadcast live video on an almost daily basis, you definitely want to follow me on Periscope as well. You can find me at Larkin Yoga TV or by searching for Brett Larkin Yoga. And Periscope's another really fun way that you can ask questions live and we can all basically just chat about yoga 24/7, because that's what I always am wanting to do. So much love from my heart to yours. Namaste.